James Melendez, James the wine guy, James the coffee guy. Today we're going to review this coffee from Sightglass. First of all, coffee is described as one of the most complex beverages on the planet. That is even more complex than wine. I've read one article where it gave maybe 10,000 characteristics in terms of flavor profile. That's pretty amazing when you think about it. And ultimately, it's given probably 10 times more complexity than wine. You got to wonder, maybe the 9,000 descriptions, what are they? What do they taste like? What is, maybe one of those 10,000 notes or one of the 9,000 notes that I'm not familiar with, what might that taste like? But I think ultimately, I don't want to talk about this video as being something that's so difficult and not understandable. I think coffee is to be appreciated by anyone who wants to enjoy it. And that's a viewpoint that I have here, and that's the reason for this video. And a passion about the beverage art form. So we don't live in the best of times, but we definitely live in the best of beverage art times. And fantastic coffee here. So proper introduction. Sightglass. Been going here since the very beginning. So when there used to be a small little cart annex to an art gallery, now they are in that art gallery space at 7th and Folsom Streets. This is from Getchegole, Ethiopia. And I love the packaging and the tagging. It's really well done. So Ethiopian heirloom varieties, of course, the the birthplace of coffee. Very high elevation, 1890 meters above sea level, coming from Elabobor. And characteristics on this are fantastic. So what I do in many a professional tasting is I go through, you're going to taste without milk, and because you want the essence of the coffee. Nothing wrong with milk. You can definitely do that. But ultimately, I'll do that tasting. So I did that originally before doing this taping right now. I did pour some milk in this, but I wrote down my notes before doing that. So here we go. Beautiful scent characteristics. Extremely earthy, almost caramel and floral notes here. Warm stones is what I'm getting from this. Chocolate, smoke, and a bit of graphite as well. So here we go. Take a taste of this coffee. Give you some flavor characteristics and a point score. Absolutely lyrical, elegant, identifiably Ethiopian. Now I'm going to do more reviews of other coffees beyond Ethiopia, which I really have a hard time because I've talked about Ethiopian coffees. I drink it every day, and I keep going back to it. But ultimately, this is an elegant coffee. It's refined. It's actually one of my favorite Ethiopian coffees, and I look forward to doing more reviews of other producers as well. So what I'm getting from this is rose petal tea, smoke, cinnamon, a bit of lime peel on this quince, and ripe white nectarine, which I think is a really great descriptor for this very complex, beautiful, and appreciable Ethiopian coffee. This is a 9.5 out of my 10.0 scale. You can think of that, as 95 points out of 100 points. Beautiful coffee. Fantastic. Thank you so much for watching, and salud.